Officers accompanied them as they went through the house. Later, they stood on the patio at the back of the house, chatting with Captain Ron Barker. "We talked about their childhood days and how much fun they'd had here as kids," Barker recalled later. He also remembered Susie making some mention of Nana's will. An inappropriate time for that, he thought. He thought a couple of other things were odd about Susie's behavior that day. "I've investigated a lot of murders," he said. "Usually the family asks you all kinds of questions. They stay on you constantly." Not one question did she ask. The other thing he noticed was this. She was cheerful. She didn't seem remorseful at all. Rob was late getting home for his appointment with Gentry, and Gentry and SBI agent Walt House were waiting for him. They talked for several hours, going over family background, the events of the past week. They talked about wills. Rob estimated his grandmother's estate at nearly $1 million, his parents at about $750,000. He mentioned that his grandfather once kept large sums of money at the house, causing concern in the family that somebody might find out about it and rob him. After Pawpaw's death, $15,000 had been found hidden away. Perhaps somebody thought money was still stashed there. He told about the upcoming hearing and his father's plan to testify in behalf of longer visitation. He said that his sister suspected Tom of criminal activity, but he would be surprised if it were true. What Rob did not mention was his own suspicions. On the way home from Nana's house Sunday night, he and Tom Mayer had talked about who might have committed the murders. They had agreed that Fritz was the most likely suspect. But Rob said nothing of this, nor did he tell about how his family was troubled about Susie's relationship with Fritz. Only when Gentry asked, "Does anybody in the family have an unusual interest in weapons?" did Rob speak his cousin's name.